or do you let your morals hold over you? If your life was a storybook, would you cast yourself as a hero or a villain? I don't know if you guys think about it a lot, but I do. My therapist told me that I have a little bit of a hero complex. What she told me that means is that I care for others so much, and I will help them so much, that I often lack the ability for self-preservation. It's an ongoing battle of S and S, selfishness versus selflessness for me, and many others. And I'm here today to explain why that people like me can care so much for others, but often forget to be kind to ourselves. First, I'm going to explain where morals, the basis of this dilemma, come from. As from a young age, the good and bad of being overly good, and the push to teach myself to not only be kind to others too, but to be kind to myself. I'll start off with being young. When we're young, our morals are taught to us by our parents or any adults in our lives. We're taught to be good and bad, and what is right and what is wrong. My mom's favorite movie to watch with me when I was little was Cinderella. We used to look at the screen together, and she would tell me, "Kenzie, I want you to be just like her. She's strong, she's kind, she's patient, and she is nice to everyone, and her dreams come true." I said, "Yes, Mom, you'll do that." And I did. A little bit too much at times, and like Abby said in her speech, I may have become a people pleaser at one point, but I'm working on that. First Cry Parenting gives a list of good advice to give your children when they're young, to teach them empathy and kindness. But the website for young parents also stresses to teach it in a manner that is not unhealthy. There's a movie from the Cinderella movie, remade in 2015. The quote goes, "Have courage and be kind." I love that quote. It was the background on my phone for a really long time. But I suggest that we add a little phrase at the end that adds, "Have courage and be kind to everyone, including yourself." On to my second point. I love my friends. I love them so much. My friends are my family, and I would do anything for them. But I learned recently that that promise holds a lot of weight. And my therapist told me there is a breaking point. That breaking point is called burnout. It's a point where you give so much to something, it causes you so much stress and fear and worry that it feels like you're drowning. This can be stopped. You just need to focus on what is going on and what you are feeling. But if you do not focus on it and you keep ignoring it and you let this stress and overwhelming build up, it can turn into something else. That something else is a scary word called depression, and another one called compassion fatigue. Compassion fatigue is an illness felt by activists, teachers, presidents, police officers, and many people in positions that force you to care a lot about others, that forces your brain to feel so much and go through so much trauma when you're caring about people that it shuts down your emotions. And sometimes you lose your empathy completely, which is kind of terrifying. Don't get me wrong, I love helping people. If I could spend all day working for charities and helping my friends and listening to people's issues and trying to help them through, I would. But I know now that I need to check on myself first before I go into those situations. Psychology Today gives a definition of burnout. Defines it as overwhelming stress. Kind people often look happy on the outside. That's why I'm giving this speech today. Because sometimes when you look just a little bit further, you can notice something's off. a breaking point. I hit my breaking point this past summer. I was going through a ton of burnout, and then my family came to me with some news that really broke my heart, and I've been struggling with that ever since. I was put in therapy because of it, because my burnout turned into something else. I learned a lot of lessons because of that. That's why I'm here to warn you. Healthline.com, a site for health and care for yourself, gives a list of warning signs for burnout. Includes exhaustion, isolation, escape to fantasies, and many more. It stresses that you need to be self-aware of your issues if you're ever going to fix them. And it gives a list of prevention methods that you can give yourself so you don't end up in a bad place. It takes a lot of time and work, but there are people there to help you. And I know that you can get through it if you are ever going through this, because I did, and I'm doing better, but it takes work every day. As a review, we went over where your morals come from at a young age. How you are taught by those around you. How playing a hero all the time can be bad for your health. And how it's okay to be selfish sometimes and look out for yourself first. And focus on you so you know what's wrong. Having courage to be kind also means being kind to yourself. Write your own story first and make sure